Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and avoid potential life-threatening situations, you could miss it.
Life moves pretty fast. You don't stop and look around once in a while, you could miss it.
That's a classic line from Ferris Bueller's Existential Crisis, and today we're looking at some of those who actually lived through them. From a guy who survived 2 months in freezing conditions to a man who somehow survived a helicopter crash and a volcano. Let's meet 15 people who cheated death and lived to tell the tale. Number 15. Peter Skylberg. How long could you survive in a temperature of minus 30 degrees Celsius? Or minus 22 Fahrenheit? Probably not long. Yet somehow, Peter Skylberg managed to survive for 2 months. 2 whole months.
The 45-year-old who's recovering in hospital is said to be doing well.
How the heck does that happen? It's a crazy, crazy story. It all happened when Skylberg crashed his car into the snow in northern Sweden. With no food and snow rapidly piling up on top of his car, Skylberg was facing a dire situation that would almost certainly result in his death. But 2 months later, when officers found the car and began digging, they were shocked to find Skylberg alive and well, wrapped up in the backseat of his car. After being taken to the hospital, Skylberg explained to the officers how he managed to cheat what should have been certain death. He was eating the snow and staying warm. It's a miracle. Experts now believe that the reason Skylberg was able to survive so long is all down to the igloo effect of his vehicle. Whatever the reason, this is a wild story. Oh boy, I really hope he wasn't eating the yellow snow. Before we go on, like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. It's time for the rare topic. And yes, today is a rare occurrence. This photo captures the aftermath of what must have been a terrifying moment. Apparently, this driver narrowly missed what could have been an unfortunate way to die when the contents of a log truck happened to fly off and smash right through the windshield. Thankfully, of course, she survived, although some would question exactly how she could have dodged something like this. But what do you think? Is this a real near-miss disaster, or just a behind-the-scenes still from Final Destination 2? Comment down below with the hashtag #RareTopic and let us know your opinion about what we just showed on screen. With that said, let's keep things moving. Number 14. Michael Benson. A helicopter filled with passengers flies directly above the world's most active volcano. What could possibly go wrong? It sounds like the setup to a subpar disaster B-movie. But this is reality, my friends, and predictably it all went very, very wrong. Against all the odds, it turns out that piloting a helicopter over an active volcano is maybe not such a great idea. The helicopter soon crashed a short distance away from the lava. A minor miracle, when you really think about it. Authorities managed to rescue everybody involved in the crash the next day, except for Michael Benson, a passenger who had gone missing. Eventually, he was discovered lying in a volcanic crater beneath a thick layer of boiling, noxious volcano fumes. What a fun time had by all. The efforts to rescue Benson were delayed by weather conditions, but eventually Benson managed to make his way out of the crater, a lucky escape. It can't be understated how much of a miracle it is that nobody got hurt. Flying a helicopter over a very active volcano is just asking for some trouble. These people are incredibly lucky to be alive. Still, what a story to tell your friends. I survived a helicopter crash in a volcano. Really beats the old, my kid won the spelling bee. Number 13. Aaron Ralston. If you somehow don't know Aaron Ralston's story, you must have spent a good chunk of the 21st century with your fingers in your ears. Ralston's story is a classic example of what I would refer to as an absolute frickin' nightmare. In 2003, Ralston suffered a horrific canyoneering accident while descending a Utah canyon solo. After dislodging a boulder, Ralston's right wrist was pinned to the side of the canyon wall. Despite his best efforts, there was no way he could have possibly freed his arm.
And it slid in like I was sliding it into a pat of warm butter.
After an unbelievable 5 days, he amputated his arm using a dull pocket knife before beginning his journey back to the real world, making his way through the rest of the canyon, rappelling 65 feet down and hiking 7 miles to safety. It's truly an unbelievable true story and a perfect example of someone pushing their own boundaries to survive. Despite this truly horrific experience, Ralston refused to just abandon mountaineering. In fact, he really just pushed forward harder than ever. He would later become the first person to climb all of the Colorado's 14ers solo in winter. Pretty sure if I lost my arm, I wouldn't risk anything more than a trip to the grocery store to refill on Oreos, so good for him. Number 12. Anna Begenholm. In this natural world of ours, there are so many horrific and unpleasant ways to die, but drowning under ice sounds like one of the worst, combining two torturous situations into one altogether nightmarish new one. And yet, Anna Begenholm survived. While skating near a waterfall, Dr. Anna Begenholm fell headfirst into freezing water below her and found herself trapped beneath the ice. She soon found a small air pocket, which allowed her to breathe, but only for around 30 or 40 minutes.
Turned around on my back and started to slide on the back.
After that, the effects of the cold and exhaustion pushed her back underwater for an unimaginable 40 minutes. That's right. She was under the ice for around 80 minutes in total. Eventually, she was rescued and brought to the hospital, where the unexpected happened. Despite her heart being stopped for 2 hours and having an unbelievably low body temperature, two things that typically end in death, Begenholm was brought back to functionality within 9 hours. It's a miracle! Due to the conditions in which she was trapped, Begenholm lost some fine motor control in her hands and feet, but suffered no brain damage. That's almost unheard of, but it just goes to show how incredible this story really is. Number 11. Roy Sullivan. How many times can a human survive being struck by lightning? If you ask Roy Sullivan, the answer would be 7 times at least. Apparently, this man is just a human lightning rod and he's still alive to tell, well, all 7 tales. Roy Sullivan is a Virginia forest ranger.
That blame radio started going off, something about storm coming up.
Who has somehow been struck by lightning 7 times and survived. Of course, he's not Superman. Every time he's been struck by lightning, he's incurred some pretty painful injuries, from toenails falling off to having some serious burns to having his hair set on fire, multiple times. But despite all of these potentially life-ending injuries, Sullivan is still alive and kicking and eager to tell the tale. Or tales. One of his favorites is pointing out that his 7th lightning strike coincided with the 22nd time he fought off a bear with a stick. This guy has truly lived his life. I imagine scientists worldwide wishing they could analyze Sullivan's body because I'm not sure it's normal to survive 7 lightning strikes. Still, I guess we can disprove that old saying of lightning never strikes twice. It's taken such a disliking to this guy that it struck 7 times. Number 10. Eva Wisniewska. You can't talk about people who survived extreme conditions without mentioning Eva Wisniewska, a German paraglider who somehow survived the impossible: extreme cold, a lack of oxygen, and lightning. All 3-in-1 horrific experience, and she's still alive to talk about it. In 2007, despite weather reports that were anticipating intensely violent thunderstorms in Australia, Wisniewska decided to train for the 2007 Paragliding World Championship. Unsurprisingly, that decision turned out to be a bad one. Shortly after she started flying, Wisniewska was sucked into the current of a cumulonimbus cloud, a cloud responsible for large, heavy rains. Unable to get out, she was soon lifted to an altitude of 32,631 feet, almost as high as your average passenger plane. Because the conditions inside cumulonimbus clouds are so intensely low, it's a wonder she survived at all. By the time she landed 3.5 hours later, she was around 37 miles away from her starting position. Wisniewska was lucky to walk away from this incident with her life intact. In this exact same weather event, another paraglider lost his life after being struck by a lightning strike. Don't mess with the weather, kids. Number 9. Joe Simpson. Joe Simpson should not be alive today. The circumstances of his story are so dangerous, the odds so stacked against him, that it would be easy to assume that he had no chance of survival. And yet, here we are. Joe Simpson and Simon Yates were climbing the Peruvian Andes when the nightmare began. After breaking his leg, Simpson needed to get to safety as quickly as possible, and Yates quickly put a plan into place. Using a rope, Yates began lowering Simpson down the mountain ledge to safety. Unfortunately, when it became clear they ran out of rope, Yates had to make a difficult decision. He had to cut the rope to save himself. Amazingly, Simpson landed on a ledge without injury, and soon began an incredible journey, crawling 6 miles over 4 days before eventually reaching the camp, where Yates was waiting. But that was an awkward situation. Simpson's experience is a pretty insane story, but it once again illustrates how humans will do anything to survive. But let me ask you guys, would you cut the rope to save yourself? Let us know in the comments. Number 8. Tsutomu Yamaguchi. I'm sure that the history of Japan is filled with people who survived the inevitable, but the story of Tsutomu Yamaguchi is something on a whole other level. This is the true story of a man who survived 2 nuclear attacks. On August 6th, 1945, Yamaguchi was in Hiroshima for a business visit on his last day in town. But, of course, early in the morning, an American bomber dropped a little boy, wiping out almost the entire population of Hiroshima. Yamaguchi suffered severe burns from the blast, as well as 2 ruptured eardrums. 3 days later, Yamaguchi returned home to his wife and son in his hometown, Nagasaki. In another cruel twist of fate, the Americans dropped a 2nd bomb, Fat Man, an even more powerful weapon that destroyed the whole city. Somehow Yamaguchi, his wife, and his son survived. Incredible! Of course, Yamaguchi wasn't totally unharmed by his exposure to radiation. While he did become pretty sick as a result, he went on to recover and lived a normal life with his family for the rest of his days. After what he went through, I'd say he deserved that. Number 7. Vesna Vulovic. It's not every day that someone receives a Guinness World Record for something they didn't actually choose to do. But Vesna Vulovic is the world record holder for surviving the highest fall without a parachute. The circumstances, of course, are grim. Vulovic was a Siberian flight attendant.
Kamenice u Czechoslovačkoj. Explodirao je moj avion.
Who happened to be on a JAT flight 367 in 1972. If you're not familiar with that particular flight, it's notable for one reason. A briefcase bomb exploded in the baggage compartment, leading the plane to crash in Czechoslovakia. Vulovic was the only survivor and is believed to have fallen some 33,330 feet without a parachute. And again, she survived. After the incident, Vulovic was in a coma for days and was hospitalized for months. Despite her many broken bones, she made a full recovery, had no memory of the incident, and was perfectly happy to continue working as a flight attendant. While I'm not sure most of us would be quite so eager to get back to work after this incident, you have to admire Vulovic's courage. Although I'm not sure she was pleased about having a world record for something so, well, unpleasant. Number 6. Louis Samperini. Like, well, everyone on this list, Louis Samperini's story is unimaginable.
And I felt it was proper. I sent her one of my Purple Hearts.
This is a man who was put through the absolute ringer and somehow managed to come out on the other side, completely unharmed. While serving as a bombardier in World War II, Samperini's plane suffered a malfunction that sent him crashing into the ocean. After drifting on a lifeboat for 47 days, he eventually landed on Japanese-occupied territory, where he was captured and taken to prison camps in Japan. There, he was beaten and tortured by the Japanese military, who tried to convince him to endorse Axis power propaganda. When he refused, Samperini was sent back into the prisoner of war camp and lived later sent to work at another in a coal factory. When he was eventually released, Zamperini struggled to move beyond what he had experienced. Eventually, Zamperini became a Christian evangelist with a strong belief in forgiveness. After moving past his troubled history, Zamperini turned his attention to helping at-risk youth, something he was committed to for the rest of his peaceful life. Number 5. Harrison O'Keen. If by now you haven't come to appreciate the sheer power of human will, Harrison O'Keen's story will undoubtedly convince you. O'Keen survived what must have been one of the most traumatic things a person can, a shipwreck. In 2013, O'Keen was a cook on board the Jackson 4, one of the only 12 crew members crossing the Atlantic. Unfortunately, the ship capsized 12 miles off the Nigerian coast, leaving the crew members to frantically search for some kind of life-saving equipment. O'Keen couldn't find anything and was trapped inside the boat for an unbelievable 3 days. The only thing he had in his possession was one bottle of Coke to survive on. After 60 hours, divers returned, looking to recover the corpses of those on board. Against all the odds, they found that one of the crew was alive. Unbelievable! The other 11 crew members tragically lost their lives in the shipwreck, but O'Keen survived and credits his faith in God for his triumph. And having heard about the nightmare that he went through, I'm inclined to agree with him. He certainly has a guardian angel. Number 4. Julianne Kopka. Imagine having a real near-death experience at the age of 17. I mean, a real near-death experience. Not I almost didn't get tickets to the concert, but then I did. Wow, I thought I was gonna die. Kinda near-death experience. Was on the Lanzas Flight 508, a flight that would soon become infamous due to its devastating crash. Kopka survived, making her the only person on board to survive this horrifying ordeal. Having somehow survived a 9,842-foot drop, Julianne survived with just a few minor cuts and bruises. But now she faced an even bigger challenge, living in the jungle alongside the wild animals until help arrived. Julianne survived 11 days alone in the Amazon rainforest before she was rescued by locals and reunited with her father. That she even survived any part of this whole disaster is a miracle in itself. Kopka really does have somebody looking out for her, because this story is just one nightmare scenario after another. And yet, against all the odds, she somehow managed to survive. That's a hell of a superhero origin story. Number 3. Amanda Eller. 17 days, thousands of volunteers, miles of forest, one missing girl. The story pretty much writes itself, but of course, this story has a happy ending, as the missing girl was discovered against all the odds. For over 2 weeks, Amanda Eller's friends and family had been fearing the worst. Her car had been found empty, near a huge forest reserve in Hawaii, suggesting that something grisly or unfortunate had happened. They soon recruited thousands of volunteers to help search the forests and streams nearby, while putting together a $50,000 reward for information. And sure enough, those volunteers found Amanda Eller safe and alive, albeit with a broken leg, sunburns and scraps, and a broken bone in her knee. But the point is, they found her alive, and that's what really matters, isn't it? It's no small feat to survive for 17 days in an unforgiving wilderness like the Hawaiian forest. But Amanda Eller somehow managed. In her words, "The only option I had was life or death." And to her credit, I think she made the same decision most of us would. Number 2. Frain Selak. Now, when the day comes that the Guinness World Records people finally decide to crown the world's unluckiest man, I'd like to recommend Frain Selak, a Croatian man with seemingly the worst and also the best luck in the world. Seriously, this guy is... oof. In 1962, Selak's bad/good luck began when a train he was traveling on flipped off the tracks and crashed into a river. Selak survived with a broken arm and some hypothermia. A year later, during his first and only plane ride, he was blown out of a malfunctioning door and landed on a haystack. Years later, a bus he was on skidded off the road and into a river. After that, he was teaching his son how to hold a gun, forgot to take the safety off, and shot himself in the, misters. Years later, he got in two separate accidents where his car caught fire. In total, Selleck has 7 near-death experiences under his belt, which he somehow managed to survive. The guy's unkillable. Depending on your appreciation, Selleck is either the unluckiest or luckiest man that has ever lived. But there is a happy ending. After suffering through all this chaos, Selleck managed to win $1 million in a lottery. I guess it does pay to get shot in the chestnuts. That's a joke, by the way, guys. Please don't do that. Number 1. Captain Tim Lannister. At this point, we know for a fact that accidents can, do, and will happen in any and all industries. But if there's one place you don't want an accident, it'll be this guy. You know, like a flight. In 1990, Captain Tim Lannister and his co-pilot left Birmingham Airport on a British Airways flight to Malaga, Spain. Less than 15 minutes into the flight and traveling over 17,300 feet above the ground, a loud bang in the cockpit was suddenly followed by a big chunk of the window blowing out, resulting in immediate decompression. This is, I think it's fair to say, an absolute horror scenario. Because the pilots had loosened their harnesses, Lancaster found himself being forcefully dragged towards the open window, with the whole top half of his body pulled outside and his legs catching on the flight controls. As his head repeatedly banged against the side of the cockpit, a flight attendant held onto him, believing that he could be sucked into the engine if he were to let go. Once the plane made an emergency landing, Lancaster was somehow found alive and was quickly rushed to the local hospital. Thankfully, he survived, but the ordeal was never forgotten by those traumatized on board, crew, and passengers. Have you ever cheated death? Let us know in the comments. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.